What's up, you guys, and welcome back to the channel. Welcome to the first time viewers, and I hope you enjoy this financial update on Tuesday, April 28th. Chances are you guys aren't already subscribed to the channel. Over 70% of my viewers aren't subscribed. So if you're one of them, click the subscribe button below. I really appreciate it, and it gets me that much closer to having 1,000 subscribers so that I can monetize my channel so that I don't have to sit in this seat anymore. So over the weekend, the feds have officially released a new rule on savings accounts. No longer are you restricted to your 6 transactions per month, although there is a caveat to that, and that is that the banks have the discretion whether they want to change this rule or not. The feds just are no longer requiring that this rule be in place. I wouldn't be surprised if a lot of banks leave it so that they can make their money from their fees and whatnot. Although I wouldn't be surprised with how the world is being pushed more towards a consumer-friendly market if banks eventually get rid of this, or banks immediately get rid of this in order to make the consumer happy and please the consumer. For now, my bank hasn't changed, but I wouldn't be surprised again if some of them do change in the near future. This being said, there's still the same bills you guys have seen all over the internet going around through Congress, possibly giving $2,000 per person and then $1,000 per month thereafter per person. There's a whole slew of them. In reality, what matters most is that you guys are staying safe and doing your best to stay financially stable. The most immediate impact you can have on your personal finances is looking at where you can cut costs, whether that be a car wash or a gym membership, or whether that be out to eat food, or I don't know, any extra costs that you have. Look at cutting those costs if you're either out of a job right now or you are in need of some extra cash right now. That's going to be your most immediate income that you can come by. Relying on a future stimulus check, it's not sure that it's going to be coming, and obviously it's not sure of how much it's going to be. So look at where you can cut costs right now is what I would recommend. Also, guys, as far as the PPP and the EIDL, those are kind of still in the middle. SBA hasn't done any progress on it. Currently, I know Chase Bank is accepting applications again for the PPP, but they're obviously waiting on the SBA to make those funds available. So they're just accepting applications and submitting them to the SBA, but that doesn't mean that you'll get your money. The SBA still hasn't made that money available yet. So still waiting on that, and I will keep you guys updated as far as when that goes live again. Also, if you haven't already, click the WeBull link below, and if you sign up, you'll get one free stock, and if you deposit $100, you'll get another free stock valued up to $1,400, and it'll be no less than $12. So it's an immediate 12% return on your $100. You can't really beat that anywhere else. If you guys have any ideas for future videos, comment down below. I have a ton of ideas that I want to talk about, but I want to talk about what you guys want to hear about. So comment below, let me know what you would like to hear about, and I'll try to make a video in the near future for you. Anyway, guys, thanks so much for watching. And if you like this video, click the subscribe button below so that you can see more next time. I appreciate it so much, and I hope you guys have a wonderful day, and I'll see you next time. Thanks.